so much in any school. We are the BFF team. Today we would like to read you a story called Do Not Wash This Bear by Sam Hay, illustrated by Nick East. Let's get started. My daddy is not very good at doing the washing. He made my t-shirt teach me. He turns my vest pink and he disappeared my socks. So when he wanted to wash bear, I cried no. But daddy didn't listen.
Here's nails, he said. Bear is muddy and grubby and needs it clean.
Wait, I said, and I showed daddy the label under bear's bottom. Daddy still didn't listen. He popped Bear into the washing machine. Bear whizzed and whirled, round and round. Soapy and sloshy, foamy and frothy. Then Daddy opened the door. Oh no, washing Bear was a big mistake. Bear was different. He waved at me. He winked at me. He blew a raspberry. Look, Daddy, I yelled, but Daddy's too busy looking for lost socks. To see what Bear was up to, suddenly Bear jumped out of the wash basket and ran up the stairs. Stop, I said, but Bear didn't listen. He bounced into my bathroom, started making bubbles, big bubbles. Stop, I shouted. But Bear still didn't listen. He ran into my bedroom, started making snow. Too much snow. Stop! I sneezed, but Bear still didn't listen. The roly-poly bounded home, jumped on a cat, and took off down the stairs. Stop that bear, I hollered, but Daddy had so much washing, he couldn't see what Bear was up to. Crash! Just then, the front door opened. Mommy, I cried. Mommy looked at a bear, then she looked at Daddy, and then he shook her head. You should have read the label, she said. Do not wash this bear. Mommy grabbed Bear by the ear, carrying him, kicking and grumbling out in the garden, and pegged him on the line to dry. Very soon, Bear was back to his old self again. Daddy said Bear smelled better now. Then he picked up the rabbit. Hooey, Daddy said. Rabbit needs the wash.
No!
I shouted as I pointed at the label.
Do not wash this rabbit.
The end. Thank you for attending our show. We hope you enjoy our performance. And thank you, Asia Books, for giving us a chance to express ourselves on this fantastic stage. Thank you.
Step into the magic, watch a show we're fun, we're alive. This is a celebration, every word will shine so bright. Come on, come on, come on and feel our magic. The Princess
and the Wizard, Alakazam.
Written by Julia Donaldson.
Illustrated by Lydia Monks.
Good day,
We are from Yotin Burana School. I am Pawat Unjit Watana, grade 9, and I play as the wizard.
I am Wasu Sontishai, grade 10, and I am the first narrator.
I am Nachita Samudibun, grade 9, and the second narrator.
I am Saunan Surikan Narinai, grade 10. I'm the princess and the fairy godmother.
And we are
the very best of Yotin.
Can Princess Eliza find a way to outwit the wicked wizard before it's too late?
Let's find out.
It was Princess Eliza's birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
She was just blowing out the 7 candles on her cake when a wicked wizard flew down the chimney and into the room.
Why didn't you invite me to your party?
He thundered.
Because wicked wizards like turning people to stone,
replied Princess Eliza.
So, they do,
said the wizard. And with a flick of his bony fingers, he turned the king, the queen, and all the party guests into stone. Then he laughed a horrible laugh and said to Princess Eliza,
they like capturing princesses too.
Oh no.
Just then, there was a whirring of wings and into the window flew the princess' fairy godmother. She was late for the party. When she saw what had happened, she waved her wand and said,
the princess may try 7 times to escape by changing her color and changing her shape.
The wizard just laughed his wonderful laugh and said,
changing her color and changing her shape will never help Princess Eliza escape.
Then he snapped his bony fingers again and turned the fairy godmother to stone.
The wizard whisked the princess up the chimney and carried her away to his tall, dark castle. He locked her into the cellar where she cried herself to sleep. The next day was Monday. The wizard unlocks the cellar door. He was holding the big red book which contained all his magic.
This is your first chance to escape,
he said.
I shall count to 100, and then I shall come and find you.
He opened his book, closed his eyes, and began to count.
1, 2,
Princess Eliza ran outside. The moat of the castle shone blue under the blue sky. She jumped into the water and turned herself into a blue fish.
98, 99, 100.
The wizard opened his eyes, looked in his magic book, and read,
to find where Eliza is hiding from you, look in the moat for the fish that is blue.
He fished Eliza out of the moat and took her to his kitchen, which was full of blue plates and pots and pans. They were all covered in dried up food.
So, you like blue, do you?
He said.
Then set to work and wash.
And he locked her in.
On Tuesday morning, the wizard unlocked the kitchen door. He looked at the clean plates and pots and pans, and he grunted,
chance number 2,
he said. Then he opened his book, closed his eyes, and began to count.
1, 2,
Princess Eliza ran to the farmyard. She turned herself into a yellow chick and hid in the straw.
Tick, tick, tick.
But the wizard read in his book,
the straw in the farmyard is yellow and thick. Princess Eliza's disguised as a chick.
He scooped Eliza up
and took her to a cupboard,
which was full of yellow socks.
They all had holes in them made by his pointy toenails.
So, you like yellow, do you?
He said.
Then set to work and darn.
And he locked her in. On Wednesday morning, the wizard unlocked the cupboard door, looked at the darn socks, and grunted,
chance number 3,
he said, and he opened his book, closed his eyes, and began to count.
1, 2,
Princess Eliza ran to the meadow. She changed herself into a green grasshopper and hid among the grass blades.
Chirp, chirp,
but
chirp,
the wizard
chirp.
Read in his book,
the grasshopper princess is easily seen, chirping away in the meadow chirp, so chirp, green. Chirp,
chirp. He caught Eliza in a net and took her to the green bathroom. The bath, basin, walls, and floor were covered in the wizard's slimy toothpaste.
So, you like green, do you?
He said.
Then set to work and wipe.
And he locked her in.
3 more days went by. Each day, the princess tried to escape. On Thursday, she turned herself into an orange fox and hid in a pile of orange leaves.
On Friday, she turned herself into a purple
Fletcher, butterfly,
and fluttered among some purple flowers.
On Saturday, she turned herself into a black cat and lurked in a black tunnel.
But each time the wizard found her and gave her yet more work to do.
On Sunday morning, the wizard came onto the roof where Eliza had been scrubbing the sooty chimney pots. Instead of grunting, he laughed his horrible laugh.
This is your last chance,
he said.
If I catch you this time, you must stay and work for me for the rest of your life.
Then he opened his book, closed his eyes, and began to count.
One, two,
Princess Eliza turned herself into a white gull and flew up into a cloud. But as she hovered above the roof, where the wizard was still counting, she saw words forming on the page of his open book.
So that's how he finds me,
she cried.
I shall never escape.
Then she had an idea. She turned herself into a page of the wizard's book. A perfectly blank white page with no writing on it.
98, 99, 100.
The wizard finished counting and began to read his book.
The princess turned into a bird in the sky. She hid in a cloud. Then she had one more try.
That was the end of the page. The wizard turned over to read more, but there was no more. The next page in his book was blank and white.
He flew into a rage.
Ah, you stupid book.
He shouted.
And he hurled it into the moat.
The book landed with a splash and sank to the bottom.
All the wizard's magic was gone. Poof. At that moment in the palace, the king and queen and all the party guests came back to life.
Where?
They asked each other. Nobody knew except the fairy godmother, and she only smiled and said nothing.
Princess Eliza had turned herself from a white page into a blue fish and was swimming to the edge of the moat.
She turned herself into a yellow chick and ran across the corn in the farmyard.
She turned herself into a green grasshopper and hopped over the grass.
She turned herself into an orange fox and raced through the orange leaves.
She turned herself into a purple butterfly.
She turned herself into a black cat and streaked through the black tunnel.
Then she turned herself into a white bird and flew all the way back to the palace and in through the window.
She perched on a chair at the tea table and changed herself.
Back into a princess!
Yay!
The king and queen and all the party guests hugged her.
Eliza, you're back!
Huh? My daughter, you're back!
Then Princess Eliza cut her birthday cake and everyone had a slice.
Happy birthday to you!
The end. The princess and the wizard.
So long.
Farewell.
We need to say goodbye.
Adieu, adieu to you and you and you.
My name is Anjali.
My name is Anisha.
And my name is Zoe.
Good afternoon, judges and everybody else.
We are the Busy Bees from Bangkok Patina Schools.
We hope you enjoy our performance.
So what do you have? Do you know Shu, the Busy Bees? My dad won't be in Bangkok Patina. Now, how many countries from the country and how many of you have?
If only I could be a bee.
before everybody settled down for a nap.
The beach showed him all the adventure in daytime.
And Norman was really into that waggly dancing.
Waggle, 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 waggle.
And then it was time to go home.
Beach school is amazing, thought Norman. He couldn't wait to come back the next day.
The next morning was even better.
Give it out to the Busy Bees.
Gentlemen, we are the Juicy Dinosaurs from Wells International School. My name is Chae-Jin Shin, and I'm from South Korea.
My name is Jae Chalatanamani, and I'm from Thailand.
My name is Laila Al-Tamimi, and I'm from Saudi Arabia.
My name is Sarayut Padapit, and I'm also from Thailand.
My name is Nantisha Narang, and I'm also from Thailand.
The Dinosaur Who Lost His Roar by Russell Punter
and illustrated by Andy Elkerton. This is a story about five dinosaurs.
Ollie
and Rex. in the middle of a big forest.
He liked living in the forest. He liked crashing through bushes.
Woohoo!
He liked climbing tall trees.
Yippee!
And he liked splashing in the river.
Wahey!
But most of all, Sid liked scaring other dinosaurs.
Roar!
He had the loudest roar of all.
One day, Sid went for a walk. He saw Spike, but Spike didn't see him. Spike was picking berries.
These look juicy.
Sid crept up behind Spike and gave a
roar!
Splat! Spike got covered in squashy berries.
That's not funny, Sid.
Said Spike. Sid just grinned and stomped on his way.
Ross was catching fish.
Come here, little fishies.
Sid crept up behind Ross and gave a
roar!
Splash! Ross fell into the water.
Ha ha!
Laughed Sid.
That's not funny, Sid.
Said Ross.
Sid just grinned and stomped on his way.
Ollie was collecting eggs for her dinner.
I'll have fried eggs tonight.
Sid crept up and gave a
roar!
Crack! Eggs went everywhere.
Ha ha ha!
Laughed Sid.
That's not funny, Sid.
Said Ollie. Sid just grinned and stomped on his way. When Sid got home, his throat hurt.
The next day, Sid went for another walk. He saw Spike picking berries. Sid crept up behind Spike and gave a
roar.
Spike laughed.
Ha ha, Sid, you've lost your roar. You can't scare me anymore.
Sid went red in the face and tiptoed away.
Sid went red in the face and tiptoed away.
Sid came to the tall trees. Ollie was collecting eggs. Sid's throat still hurt, but he wanted to roar. He crept up behind Ollie and gave a
roar.
Ollie laughed.
Ha ha, Sid, you've lost your roar. You can't scare me anymore.
Sid didn't like being laughed at. It felt bad. He didn't like having a sore throat either. So he ate a spoonful of honey, drank some warm water, and went to bed. The next day, Sid's throat was better. He decided to visit Spike, Ross, and Ollie.
I'll say sorry for scaring them,
he thought.
Then we can be friends.
Sid went to the berry bushes, but Spike wasn't there.
That's odd.
He went to the river, but Ross wasn't there.
That's funny.
He went to the tall trees, but Ollie wasn't there.
That's strange.
Sid saw some footprints. They were at the bushes and the river too. They weren't spikes.
Too long.
They weren't rosses.
Too wide.
And they weren't olive.
Too deep.
Sid followed the footprints. The footprints led to
a huge dinosaur conference.
My name is Nisha Warasakun. I am 13 years old.
Hong Kong gets the crumbs by serving him. One morning, Hong Kong got out of bed on the wrong side. And then nothing was right. His lanky Turmington couldn't be found anywhere.
Hum-room,
said Pom Pom. His baby brother, Bobo, was playing with his favorite toy.
Bang, bang, bang.
Hum-room, said Pom Pom. Pom Pom's mommy sang silly service songs of her breakfast. Where have all the flowers gone? Long time passing. His cereal was salty, and there were beasts in his juice.
Hum-room,
said Pom Pom. Then things went from best to worst. His toothbrush was too scratchy. His flannel was just
freezing.
And he couldn't do a thing with his hair.
Hum-room,
Pom Pom. After all that, it was time to go outside. The sun was too sunny, and the birds were too noisy.
Hum-room,
said Pom Pom.
Have a lovely day, girl,
said Pom Pom's mommy.
Hum-room,
said Pom Pom. In the playground, everyone was having fun. Except Pom Pom. Ask Bunny.
No.
Huffed Pom Pom.
Want to wash hands?
Ask Rocco.
No.
Rabbit Pom Pom.
Would you like to play catch?
Ask Peter.
No.
Shouted Pom Pom.
Do you want to do skipping?
Ask Gout.
Go away.
Yelled Pom Pom. And David.
Oh.
Pom-Pom didn't feel like shouting anymore. He felt sad and a bit silly. His friends had only tried to be nice.
Oops,
said Pom-Pom. And off he went to find the others.
Sorry, everyone,
said Pom-Pom.
That's okay,
said everyone.
I know,
said Buster.
Let's play chess.
Said Bundy.
Yay!
Said everyone.
Got you!
Said Bundy.
Hum-room!
Said Pom Pom. The end.
Thank you for your attention.
ขอบคุณน้องๆนะคะในทีมสุดท้ายจากมูลนิธิธรรมิกชนเพื่อคนตาบอดในประเทศไทยจังหวัดลพบุรี